Good morning, dear students. This is Sudhir Shukla. Hope you are well. Dear students, let's start our discussion for the topic GPS receiver. So, while starting about this GPS receiver, I hope you remember my words. I have told you that early 1990s, GPS was only served for surveying purpose, basically used by the military applicants. And after it all, means after 1990s, several million users were using this GPS application because the application and the uses to particular number of users were provided. That means to the civilians. So while going through this GPS receiver, first of all, let's draw a diagram of it. There is a section of antenna, and that is pre-amplifier. This is antenna, and let me draw the block which is associated with this. Is what looks like here it is code tracking loop. Here we are using earlier tracking loop. This here we are using signal processor. Here it is. This is a complete a block. Here it is precision oscillator. It is microprocessor. Here we are using memory. Here is a block of external power supply. Associated here. Here it is command and display unit. Here it is external data logger. So this is what a major components of GPS receiver. So these are the component of GPS receiver, in which the first one is antenna. That means sensitive antenna. This sensitive antenna of the GPS receiver detects the electromagnetic wave signal transmitted by GPS satellite and converts the wave energy to electric current that amplifies the signal strength and sends them to receiver electronics. So commonly used GPS antennas are monopole or dipole, spiral helix, quadrifilar helix, microstrip, patch, and a choke ring. So these are very important. Let me write ki generally used antennas are commonly used GPS antennas are antennas are monopole or dipole or spiral helix or quadrifilar helix or microstrip, that is patch antenna, and a choke ring. These are the namely used antennas in GPS system. The second one is RF section with signal identification. With signal identification. So the incoming GPS signal are down converted to a lower frequency in the RF section and processed with one or more channels. So receiver channel is the primary electronic unit of a GPS receiver. A receiver have one or more channels in the panel. Parallel channel concept, each channel is continuously tracking one particular satellite. So a minimum of four parallel channels is required to determine position and time. So modern receivers contain up to 12 channels for each frequency. So continuous tracking parallel channels are cheap and give good overall performance. So the third one is microprocessor. So to control, this is for controlling. To control the operation of a GPS receiver, a microprocessor is essential for acquiring the signals, processing of the signal, and the decoding of the broadcast message. That is what basically done by this microprocessor unit. So the next is precision oscillator. So to control the operation of a GPS receiver, a microprocessor is essential for acquiring the signal. Similarly, a reference frequency in the receiver is generated by this precision oscillator. So what it do? A reference frequency in the receiver is generated by precision oscillator. Usually less expensive, low performance quarter oscillator is used in receiver, since the precision clock information is obtained from the GPS satellite. So the user clock error can be eliminated through double differentiating technique. So next one is power supply, so first generation GPS receivers consumed very high power, but modern receivers are designed to continue as little energy as possible. So most receivers have an internal rechargeable, that is nickel cadmium battery, in addition to an external power supply, which I have drawn here. So the next is memory capacity. For port processing purpose, all data have to be stored on internal or external memory devices. So post processing is essential for multi-station techniques applicable to geodetic and surveying problems. GPS observations for pseudo oranges, phase data, time and navigation messages data have to be recorded. So modern receivers have internal memories of 5 megabytes or more. So some receivers, some data on magnetic tape or on hard disk using external microcomputer connected through this RS-232 port. So dear students, this is what major components of the GPS receiver. So let me draw a diagram which is a GPS receiver block diagram. This will be a receiver block diagram. So let me draw this diagram first. This is low noise. Low noise block converter. Here we are using a receiving antenna. Now this is what a digital baseband processor. Digital baseband processor. And here we are using simply a CPU unit, central processing unit. Here we are using external memory. This is code demodulator. It is local oscillator. So this is basically a GPS receiver block diagram. Got it? So in any satellite receiver, since the input power is of the order of picowatts and the C by N to be maintained to get demodulated S by N above the threshold fixed for error free processing, and which is shown in this configuration of GPS receiver. So dear students, to recover the baseband cost loop is used with phase synchronization of local oscillator, or else the signal can be detected. So the required PN code is locally generated to detect the chip of the spread spectrum received signal, and this requires as many correlators as the visible satellites So most of the receivers have 12 correlators. Diversity reception is used and the strongest signals are used for processing. So the CPU uses a software to calculate X, Y and Z coordinates and hand find latitude, longitude and altitude. And once these datas are known to us, simply we can locate an object. Its positions can be determined. So dear students, this is all for GPS receiver. Hope you have understand all those things. I always used to say, if you have any doubt regarding any of the point which I will explain to you, without any hesitation, you can directly ask to me. And I wish you will take care of yourself. Thank you, students. Thank you so much.